descriptive, analytical, fundamental, applied, exploratory, etc., etc. Oh God, so many types of research designs, and they are so similar to each other. How do we differentiate? How do we choose the appropriate one? How to understand them properly?
Well, don't you worry. This channel is going to solve all your doubts.
In this video, we are going to learn about what is descriptive research design, its examples, uses, and the different types of descriptive research design. So no more waiting and let's start learning. Let us start by understanding what descriptive research actually means. Descriptive research aims to describe or depict the characteristics, behavior, and relationships of a particular subject or group of subjects. It focuses on providing an accurate snapshot of a situation without any manipulation or interference. For an example, imagine you are interested in studying the shopping habits of teenagers in a particular city. You want to gather information about their preferred shopping locations, the factors influencing their purchasing decisions, and their spending patterns. In this case, conducting a descriptive research study would involve surveying a representative sample of teenagers and collecting data on their shopping behaviors and preferences. Now that we know what descriptive research is, let's explore its significance. Descriptive research plays a vital role in providing a foundation for further research and decision making. It helps researchers gather valuable information, identify patterns and trends, and gain insights into various phenomena. By describing a situation accurately, we can develop a better understanding of the topic at hand. Descriptive research serves as a stepping stone for other types of research, such as correlational or experimental studies. It helps researchers generate hypotheses, create survey instruments, and design experiments based on their initial observations. In short, descriptive research lays the groundwork for scientific inquiry. Moving on, let's explore the different types of descriptive research design. While there are several variations, I'll cover the most common ones you're likely to come across. The first is cross-sectional design. Cross-sectional design involves studying a sample at a single point in time. It aims to capture data from different groups or individuals and analyze the existing relationships or characteristics. For example, conducting a survey to understand the attitudes of different age groups towards climate change. Please note, this type of studies are limited to a specific period of time. Second is longitudinal study. Unlike cross-sectional design, longitudinal design focuses on studying the same group or individuals over an extended period. It allows researchers to observe changes or trends over time. For instance, tracking the physical fitness levels of a group of individuals over a span of 5 to 10 years. The next is case study design. Case study design involves in-depth examination and analysis of a particular individual, group, or situation. It focuses on generating a comprehensive understanding by collecting qualitative and quantitative data. For instance, studying the effects of a specific therapy on a single patient. Another type of descriptive research design is observational research. Observational research involves observing and recording behaviors, actions, or phenomena as they occur naturally in their real life settings. The goal is to gather data without interfering or manipulating the environment. Observational research can be conducted through direct observation or by using video recordings. For example, observing the behavior of children in a playground to understand their social interactions. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe to our channel for more educational content.